In this video, I will discuss about Brewster's Law. Brewster's Law is given by the scientist Malus. If an unpolarized light is incident on the surface of glass, this is unpolarized light. Air and glass. Then some parts of the light ray is refracted and some part is reflected. This is angle of incidence and this is angle of refraction. Both reflected and refracted rays are partially polarized, but for a particular angle of incidence, these two rays are perfectly polarized, fully polarized, and component of this ray are parallel to the plane and component of this ray are perpendicular to the plane, and this angle is known as angle of polarization, and suppose this is angle of refraction. As per Brewster's law, tangent of this angle of polarization means tan ip is equal to the refractive index of the glass, suppose it is mu. This is Brewster's law. It means we can write it sin ip upon cos ip, and by Snell's law we can write mu equal to sin ip upon sin r. Equation number 1 and equation number 2. If we equate both equations, then sin ip upon cos ip should be equal to sin ip upon sin r. This is Brewster's law and this is Snell's law. Now it is cancelled out. Cos ip equal to sin r, or we can write sin r equal to sin cos ip means sin 90 minus ip, and if we equate, r should be equal to 90 minus ip, and ip plus r equal to 90 degree. It means sum of, this is ip, and sum of ip and r equal to 90 degree. It means these two rays are right angles, or we can say that when rays are perfectly polarized, or we can say that at angle of polarization, if angle of incidence becomes equal to the angle of polarization, then deflected and refracted rays are perpendicular to each other. This is Brewster's law. Thank you.